Hi guys, CodeTutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
If you are watching this particular video, that means you have decided to learn Kotlin. And I am sure you would be itching to write a simple Hello World application in Kotlin. Well, it is pretty easy to get started. I will get started with something which you are already familiar with, that is Android Studio. So let me open Android Studio. And if you go to Tools and then come down to Kotlin, there is an option like Kotlin REPL. R-E-P-L. REPL stands for read, evaluate, print loop. So basically what this does is it will give you an environment where you can write few lines of code and execute and see what is the output to understand the behavior of any programming language. This is not very unique to Kotlin. You will find Swift REPL, Python REPL for that matter. Click on Kotlin REPL and that should basically open Kotlin REPL in the Android Studio. And you can see that here it is showing the version of the Kotlin that we are using is 1.3.31 and that is compliant with JRE 1.8, and here I can just write something like 2+2 and then command enter on a Mac machine and it should basically give me the result, which in this case is 4. So let me enter few more lines of code here. I will write a function, say hello world, and I will print hello world, welcome to Kotlin programming. And then after that, I will just invoke the hello world function. And after that, let me enter command enter again. And you can see that whatever that we had written here, that got printed because we are basically invoking hello world. And I can just enter hello world again. And it will once again print the same value, whatever that I had implemented in that particular function. If you don't want to do this, you just want to test it online, that option is also available. If you go to the Kotlin language reference documentation, there is an option like Playground, which is similar to Swift Playground that you get in the Xcode. So click on the Playground here, that should open up this particular screen. And if you write whatever standard code here and execute it, you should be able to see the result. If you are a bit lazy to do the initial setup and just want to get started with writing some simple code online and test it, you can do this as well. But I am also sure some of you might be actually interested in writing a code in a very basic simple file and see how the overall compilation process looks like. Well, to understand that, let's understand how the overall compilation process looks like from the Java's perspective and from the Kotlin's perspective. As you are aware, if you want to run a program in JVM, so typically you have a .java file which you run through a Java compiler to get a .class file, and then you basically load this particular .class file using the Java command line into the JVM to be able to run that particular standard Java program. This is how the typical Java compilation process looks like. Now, what happens in case of Kotlin? In case of Kotlin, the name of the file would be ending with .kt. So the extension for Kotlin files are .kt. Instead of using Java C, you will be using Kotlin C, which is a Kotlin compiler, and that will generate a .class file. Once you get the .class file, executing it on the JVM should be same as you would have executed in the earlier case. That is, you would still be invoking the same Java command line to execute .class file that you generated from the Kotlin compiler. So let's put this to the test. As you can see here, I have written a code here, sample.kt. Let me show you the content. By default, it is opening in the IntelliJ IDE, but I would not be running it from the IntelliJ IDE. I would be running it from the command line. So if you have a look at it, what does it contain? The name of the file is sample.kt and it has a function. The name of the function is main, arguments, string array, and then inside that I have written hello world. If you are a Java programmer or have done some kind of a programming, most of the code should be self-explanatory. Now, what we will do is we intend to run it through the command prompt. So let me open the terminal here. So let's try to run this particular sample.kt through the command prompt, kotlinc name of the file is sample.kt. That should basically give us the dot class file. And as you can see here, some extra folder and files got created here. Now we have got the dot class file. The next option should be to run this particular dot class file. You might be wondering, where is this sample.kt file name came from? We will explore that in the future video, but as of now, let's try to run this class file. And how do I run class file? Java sample kt enter. And as you can see here, it is giving an exception that some of the files are missing and it is basically not able to load this particular class file and execute. Well, the reason why this is not running is during the compilation process, we did not include Kotlin runtime. So instead of writing kotlinc sample.kt, what actually we should have written was kotlinc then sample.kt then hyphen include runtime and then hyphen d the name of the jar file that needs to be generated. So sample.jar. Now what does this mean? What are we actually trying to do is we are basically generating a jar file, sample.jar file, and when the jar file is getting generated, we want to tell that Kotlin runtime should be bundled with the jar file. You might be wondering, why should we do this? Well, in a normal Java file, when you write your Java code, the object, the string, the utils, some most of the things come default, which are part of the java.lang package. And there are many other packages which you get as a part of your Java runtime environment by default. But that is not the case when you are trying to run your Kotlin code. So when you are trying to compile your Kotlin code, you need to tell the compiler that you need to have some of the Kotlin specific libraries to be included as a part of the runtime environment. That is why I have written this compile option, that is hyphen include hyphen runtime. And now let me compile this. Once again, silly mistake, Kotlin C. And as you can see here, now we got a sample.jar file. Once we have got this particular jar file, executing it is pretty simple. You just execute it like any other jar file, that is java hyphen jar sample.jar. Let me run it, and as you can see here, now we are getting the hello world that we had written in the application. So basically, this particular statement is necessary at the compile time when you are compiling Kotlin code. We will not be doing this way of executing a Kotlin code every time. This is just for the demonstration purpose, so that you understand how the Kotlin compilation process happens and how it is slightly different from the Java compilation process. But overall, it is still the same. It is still the same bytecode that is getting generated from the Kotlin compiler, and it is still getting executed on the same JVM on which your regular Java code was getting executed. In the next video, we will actually start exploring the various features of Kotlin. So stay tuned. Bye. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.